This illegal block exists in vanilla Minecraft, and this item has over 30 enchantments on it. And today, we're covering the crazy ways the Minecraft community has beat the system. Why did we spawn 100 snow golems in the end? Well, this is why. See, by utilizing the portal in the end, we can make a perfect wither rose farm. Now, to start, we'll need to dig out a large space of 2 blocks height underneath, and then we can make a snow golem spawner to fill up the crater. After that, be sure to spawn the wither with his center block in the center of the portal, in which case, the wither will spawn, explode, and then give us a bunch of wither roses to boot. Instead of building one house, why not build 20 of them at the same time? Using this flying machine, there is no limit to the amount of houses that you can build in one sitting. And while sure, it would take some serious redstone prowess and patience to build the machine, Rome wasn't built in a day. But with this, it might have been. So if you want to construct a whole town at once, this might be your new best friend. Instead of this cow farm, what if you built one like this? Now, hear me out. With the right number of leads, we can tie a whole bunch of these dangling animals to a single fence. And that'll let us create a comical cow pen without needing a bunch of walls to keep them in place. And from there, we can walk the perimeter with a stack of wheat and breed them as usual, which lets the baby cows fall into the water basin, and then we can ship them off to whatever humane solution you have in mind. These villagers can never escape, and that's not because of any fences or redstone trap, but instead, just a honey block. See, if you nudge them in a hole with a honey block floor, they aren't able to jump off of the block, letting us keep our clerics in order for the next trading hall that we built. And hey, if you use honey blocks on the outside, then no zombies can jump in to hurt them either, which is a win-win. Normally, you can't smelt nether stem blocks or planks, but with some crafting, we can break that rule. By converting nether stem blocks into planks, then the planks into sticks, and then finally our sticks into ladders, we can use them in our furnace for fuel. And while I don't know why you'd use this over the literal lakes of lava that you have available, if you're in the nether without a bucket, it is an option. Getting the sniper duel achievement is no easy task, but that's nothing redstone can't help. And here, instead of shooting at the skeleton head on, we shoot at a target block placed directly above him. And then we rig a sticky piston to pull it away on command, meaning that after we walk 50 blocks away, we can flip the lever, activate the piston, and we'll get the achievement no problem. And hey, this will also work for the bullseye achievement. Just switch out the skeleton for a target block instead. Have you ever used a gas as a cannon? Well, apparently, if you were to stand directly where the fireball spawns in like so, you can avoid taking any damage from it. And then, since it sticks in one place, we can punch it towards our enemies. And as it turns out, this is something to do with how the game mechanics don't register the fireball hitting the player if it spawns inside their hitbox. Because when that happens, it's treated like there's no impact, letting us create this semi-automatic fire hazard. This sapling will never grow up, no matter how much you bone meal it. And the reason is that we have a little piece of string blocking it from growing. And hey, this can even work with vines, glow lichen, bamboo, and sugarcane as well. So if you're tired of watching your vines get overgrown on your wall, this could lead you to design your Ivy League in whichever way you'd like. Or do this in your friend's sugarcane farm and laugh when they don't get any profits. Now, how is this lamp powered? Well, the answer is redstone, but probably not how you'd expect it. See, this user discovered that by placing down item frames and design maps like so, they could hide the redstone underneath. So if you have a cobblestone block below, you can cap it off with its own design. Or maybe even diamonds to show off. And hey, it'll even work for hiding minecart rails like so, letting us make a secret roller coaster to get around. Apparently, it's possible to stack enchanted books, which is a weird sight, but let's explain. By putting 2 books enchanted with a curse in the grindstone, it allows you to stack them instead. And this is because you can't remove curses with a grindstone, so it just glitches out the output. And then, you can shift-click out the end result, and it'll put them all back in your inventory. This fence will keep your animals trapped, but lets us jump over just fine. See, if you arrange the shape of trapdoors flipped up like so, the mobs register it as a block from this side to jump in, but they can't jump out when inside. Which means that the next time that you go to check on your chicken coop, you don't have to worry about one of them escaping when you open up the gate. And it'll work just as well for monsters as it does for animals. But I'd be sure to keep your distance away from the creepers. Most minecarts can sit just one. This can fit up to 2. And pulling this off is super easy. All we need to do is use a boat and place it into a minecart to create a fully functional 2-seater cart. Which is possible because our boat is recognized as an entity, which allows it to get inside of the minecart. But then, since it still functions as a boat, any other mob or friend can hop into the backseat with you, making that roller coaster ride a lot less lonely. Have you ever tried sprinting backwards? Well, it sounds crazy, but with a glitch, it's possible. See, the community's found a way that if you sprint and then immediately jump in the opposite direction, you can actually sprint backwards on bedrock, which can come in handy when you need to escape from a primed creeper explosion. Just be sure to be careful not to run into any unwanted chasms. So, how do we make this waterfall in vanilla Minecraft? Well, apparently, if you have several llamas that attack your dog at the base of the waterfall, any projectiles will rise up to the top, giving us the mist effect that we're looking for. And since the spit rises up, there's no risk for the dog to take any kind of damage. So while it might not be as convincing as Dr. Forte's Cascade mod, it does substitute the other methods quite nicely. Did you know that horses can move this fast? Well, when you give potions of swiftness and jump boost to your horses, they get temporarily faster as expected. But if you breed them when the effects are still active, they pass those attributes onto their offspring. And folks, those are permanent. permanent. So if we continue to do this for generations, their speed and jumping ability will only grow over time. And as you can see, that can make for some pretty wild results. How do we place this block in a half slab? Well, normally it wouldn't work, but with the help of falling sand entities, we can make it happen. See, if you sit between two slabs and summon a falling sand block into place, that block will land right on top of the slab. And while you can't place anything on it, it does look pretty convincing, even when you step up close. Now, you can't use channeling unless you hit a mob, but these item frames count as a mob. So with one of these, we can place it down and have our own pocket solution for fixing our oxidized copper, which allows us to turn back time, in a way. And hey, it can also provide a solution for converting mobs with lightning without having to hit them with a lightning strike. And that way your brown mushroom doesn't just die on the spot. Oh, and now that that brown mushroom's alive, it apparently has a challenge for you. According to the cow, no one's ever used their knuckle to subscribe to the channel. So if you're up to the challenge, fist bump that red sub button below. It's free and it helps out a ton. Did you know we can get 30 enchantments on one item? Because as you'll see, we can use this strategy from Nembon to never see the phrase too expensive ever again. See, every time that you enchant an item, it's counted as two in the anvil, the item and the enchanted book that you used. So as long as the amount of enchantments on the books that we have matches with the amount on the item, we can work our way up to 30 enchantments at a time. That is, if only there were 30 enchantments in the game. When lava and water mix, you get stone. So why doesn't that happen here? Well, as a bizarre addition to vanilla, the community has found that by placing blocks around the water and then a warp sign waterlogged inside, we can effectively place lava above it. And the reason this works is because even though water can occupy the same space as a sign, lava can't, which makes it think that it's on top of a full block instead of a water source. This user found a way to create a dropper that you'll always survive. See, by using pistons, tripwires, and a whole lot of redstone, we can create a readily available landing pad to catch us when we fall. And as you can see, each tripwire tells the machine where you're at, meaning it'll move to your exact location so you safely fall in the water, which makes for the most complex water bucket save that I've ever seen. I wouldn't go through this end portal if I were you, because even if it looks safe, it's actually booby-trapped. See, if you drop a dripstone into an end portal, then whoever goes through next will take the point of damage, meaning that the higher you drop it, the more damage it'll do. And from a 40 block fall, that could be lethal, giving us a guarantee that the next person who goes through, even if they're wearing armor, is in for a rude awakening. So just make sure that your friend goes through first. Let's use villagers to get some unlimited diamond gear, which might sound crazy, but with the help from the armor, the weaponsmith, and toolsmith jobs, we can make it happen. First off, we're gonna need to lower the price, which we can do easily enough by zombifying a villager and then curing it back to normal. Repeat this enough and we can drop those prices drastically, even down to one emerald per trade. And then if you max out their trades to level 5, we can get some super cheap diamonds for those exploits. In Minecraft, there's knockback, knockback 2, and then the kind of knockback that launches you 1100 blocks away. Thanks to the community's discovery, it turns out that by stunning a ravager in a build like this, and then sitting in a minecart above, we can get launched hundreds of blocks away from the location. And if you're looking to extend that airtime, maybe bring an elytra as well for an even greater liftoff. And with that, folks, have a good one. All right.